Bahamas Athletics Today, coverage of the IAAF 2012 Centenary Gala in Barcelona, Spain, is brought to you by the Bahamas Ministry of Tourism, the International Association of Athletic Federations, and Consumers' Choice.
Gentlemen, it is my pleasure to welcome you to Barcelona. Barcelona is the capital of Catalonia, a country with its own history, language, and culture. For Barcelona, it is an honor to host this important event, which takes place in the centenary of the International Association of Athletics Federations. We are delighted that the best athletes in the world are today in Barcelona, a city of culture, knowledge, creativity, innovation, welfare, and sport. As you all know, Barcelona is a city passionate about athletics and the values of competition, fair play, and teamwork associated with sports. 20 years ago, Barcelona became the sports capital of the world with the organization of the Olympic Games. All the city changed. The Olympic spirit is still with us. Every day, Barcelona is an outstanding platform for the practice of all kinds of sport and outdoor activities. We have prestigious associations, clubs, and federations to help practice sport for people of all ages. So sport is a passion for us. We understand it as the basis for a healthy lifestyle and a tool for education and human development. Today, Barcelona is the world capital of athletics. Thank you. All of you, athletes of the world, are an example to follow. Thank you for your inspiration. And thank you very much for choosing Barcelona as the venue for the Let of the Year 2012. Thank you very much and enjoy our city. Thank you.
Thank you. Diak, dear mayor, members of the IAAF council, fellow athletes, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of the International Athletic Foundation, it is my esteemed pleasure to welcome you to this very special ceremony, during which the best athletes of 2012 will be presented with a prestigious series of awards, climaxing with the crowning of the male and female World Athletes of the Year. As you know, 2012 marked the centenary anniversary of the International Association of Athletics Federations. Throughout the year, 24 legends of sport have been nominated as the very first members of the IAAF Hall of Fame. These legendary athletes will be inducted into the IAAF Hall of Fame as part of the prestigious IAAF Centenary Gala tonight, a show which celebrates 100 years of athletics excellence. Right now, though, we will celebrate a fantastic year, 2012, which has seen extraordinary performances from the IAAF World Indoor Championships in Istanbul, where two world records were set, as well as the IAAF World Junior Championships held where? Right here in Barcelona. And more recently, an absolutely fabulous edition of the Summer Olympic Games in London, where no fewer than four world records were set. This year was also highlighted by the one-day meeting series of the Samsung Diamond League, the IAAF World Challenge, the IAAF World Half Marathon Championships, and other events which have made 2012 a special, very special year indeed. It is now my honor to call on stage the president and honorary president of the International Athletic Foundation, Mr. Lamine Diak, and His Serene Highness, Prince Albert of Monaco.
Finally winning the gold total 200. And Valeria Adams showing why she is such a role model in our sport. Today's ceremony is not only about who becomes athlete of the year, because a number of our awards will be presented. We have the veteran athlete of the year, the coach lifetime achievement, the rising star winner, and we also pay tribute to the media, without whom our sports athlete could not receive the attention they deserve. In this very special year, I am very proud of our exceptional past and our brilliant present, and believe that we can look to the future with plenty of confidence. Thank you very much.
President Dear-Lamine, esteemed members of the board of the International Association of Athletic Federations and International Athletic Foundation, dear Mayor of Barcelona, dear athletes, dear friends, the events surrounding the World Athletics Gala are always a privileged moment in the life of our sport, and it is once again the case for me personally for at least three reasons. First, it provides us this year with the opportunity to celebrate the centenary of the IAAF's founding. Last summer, at the occasion of the Hercules meet in Monaco, this anniversary was commemorated on July 17th, the day of the IAAF's creation. We are always aware of the importance I attach, as you all well know, the privileged ties between the Principality of Monaco and the IAAF. As next June will mark the 20th year of the implementation of the headquarters in the Principality of Monaco. The IAAF joined the International Athletic Foundation, created 26 years ago by the late Primo Nebbiolo, a foundation for which I have the honor and pleasure of serving as honorary chairman, and which is the instigator of this World Athletics Gala and other celebrations. The second reason is the initiative conducted by our Catalan friends hosting this event in Barcelona, and therefore offering us the opportunity to return. Many of us have returned many times since then, but to return to the city which successfully hosted the Summer Olympic Games, the Games of the 25th Olympiad, some 20 years ago. Finally, this event brings us together at the end of a year, a remarkable year, marked by the tremendous success of athletics at the London Olympic and Paralympic Games. On the numerous occasions I have attended the World Athletics Gala and this celebration since its creation in 1985, I've often stressed the virtues of our sport, a school of determination and discipline for our youth, and the key role in the fight for equality between human beings and equal rights for men and women alike. As this centenary year draws to an end, I'd like to stress once again how much I believe these virtues, as I'm convinced that they will continue to prevail. Look forward to this upcoming year, this upcoming season, with many exciting competitions leading up to next year's World Championships in August in Moscow. I'd like you to enjoy this wonderful celebration as we celebrate the year's best male and female athletes and all the other wonderful people involved with our sport. Wish you an enjoyable celebration. Happy centennial to the IAAF. Thank you very much.
Well, you guys don't worry about me if you see me sweating a little bit, because 8 years after I retired, I still can't get away from the ghost of Maurice Green. So now we get to the point where we start to give out some awards. Let's look at our first awardee of the day, the Female Master Athlete of the Year. In order to present the award, I have the pleasure of welcoming on stage the Senior Vice President in the IAAF, Mr. Bob Hirsch.
Well, we're
congratulations to you, Lynn. And now it's time for the Male Master Athlete of the Year. To present this award, please welcome on stage the IAAF Vice President, Dahlan Al-Hammam.
And the winner of the 2012 World Master Athletes of the Year Award is Robert Leader.
Congratulations to you, Robert. And now, it is with great pleasure that I call to the stage the IAAF Vice President, Lord Sebastian Coe, to present the IAAF World Journalist Award. So you don't get to go straight to the lectern. First of all, folks, can we get a hand for this man who organized the most fantastic Olympics? Once it was all over, where did you go on holiday?
This is probably not the country to announce this, but I went to Italy.
Okay.
For 10 days.
And then the natural follow-up question is, now that you've...
On a Frascati loading gun.
Right. Now that you put on something of this magnitude, this is the crowning achievement of your life. Where do you go from here?
It's very simple. I'm now back with my proper family, so
right.
I'm very happy.
So you're back home?
Yeah.
Okay.
And the winner of the IAAF World Journalist Award for 2012 is Elias McCorry.
Present the Coaching Lifetime Achievement Award, IAAF Vice President, many times world champion and Olympic champion, Sergey Bubka. Sergey, first question, we heard that your son had an accident. How is he doing?
Well, thank you very much. He is getting better. He is back home and now his recovery is going on.
Now your world record is getting a little old now. How much longer do you see it surviving?
I hope it will happen soon. I expect with younger generation, we try to share the knowledge and help them to be better than 6:15, 6:20, and 6:30.
So you'd like that record to fall very soon?
Of course.
Okay.
This is my duty.
Okay. Coaching Lifetime Achievement Award.
And the winner of Coaching Lifetime Achievement Awards is Glenn Mills.
And now we move on to a category very near and dear to my heart. Of course, 20 years ago when I was world junior champion, this award didn't exist. But anyway, we move on. In order to present the Female Rising Star Award, I'm honored to ask on stage a former teammate, three-time Olympic champion, and arguably one of the most graceful sprinters to ever step on a track, Miss Marie-Jo Perrin. For those of you who are not as plugged in as I am, you may not know that Marie-Jo is now the head of the Guadeloupean Federation. Congratulations to you.
Thank you very much.
So the question is, you're living a lovely life, you have your son, life is good. Why did you decide to get back into track and field at an administrative level?
I guess I will say after 10 years of being with my family, taking care of my family, I decided it was time for me to go back, and help my community.
So you wanted a challenge, and a challenge you shall have.
And the winner of 2012 World Rising Star Award is Antonik Spong.
Award will be presented by the one and only three-time world champion, two-time Olympic champion, world record holder from the Czech Republic. Please welcome Mr. Jan Zalesny. Okay, so Jan used to set records and win gold medals. Now you're coaching. A little bit different, a little bit more nerve-wracking to be in the stands and not having that control?
Yes, of course, coaching is much more difficult than I compete.
That's why I don't do it.
Because I'm sitting on the tribune, but I wish my athletes, but I am so satisfied with you because it's, you just love the ceremony, European Championships and Diamond League and Barbara Shpotakova on Olympic Games and also Diamond League.
Now I'm going to go off script now, the producers will love that. My country just had the javelin Olympic champion, you might have heard. How good can he be?
I'm so glad because he's very young. He helped the javelin and I would like to see him next year at the World Championships. And I believe him. I believe he'll take another more medal.
Well, my country thanks you.
And the winner of the 2012 World Rising Star Awards is Keshon Wolcott.
Okay, so we are quickly approaching the climax of our awards presentation. Our next award is of particular importance. After what was arguably one of the greatest Olympic Games in modern history, one which was very much in line with the 2012 London competition model of inspiring a generation, I am honored now to call upon Mr. Kip Kano to present the IAAF Inspirational Award. You inspired so many people with your running. Who do you enjoy watching? When you're in London, you're sitting among the dignitaries and you're watching London. David Rudisha aside, who else do you enjoy watching?
I enjoyed watching, especially the women event and the men's event. Our stars from Kingston, Jamaica.
Now I know you competed back in Jamaica back in your day. Is that why you enjoy watching the Jamaican team perform?
Yeah, I did compete in Kingston, Jamaica in 1966, and I was encouraged by the youth of that
company. It's pretty good. Fantastic. So distance runners can be encouraged by sprinters, and not the other way around. Yeah, inspirational. <again. laughs>
The most inspiring award for 2012 is Iris Mariti. Iris
Now, I've watched you make teams in the past, in injured at the World Championships before you got a chance to run, but this has been 2012, just an amazing season for you. World indoor champion, world record, Olympic gold, so you've gotten everything handled. The first question that I, as a stat guy, I want to know is, how much faster can this record go?
as Ronaldo said at the press conference, it's going to take a lot of extra help to run faster than 1280, and by extra help I mean competition. The competition needs to be at 1280 also for the record to drop below to 127. So I think I can do it, but he thinks otherwise.
he doesn't think you can pull it off.
I'm sure he thinks I can pull it off, but he's thinking I'm going to need some help, like with competition, to push me to a faster time.
Now, I discovered on the way over here that he's never trained with a training partner since he left college. So everything that he has done, he's accomplished basically going against ghosts in practice. How is it that you're able to do that? And with so many people in here, most of the people seated here have training partners that push them. We have Bolton Blake over here, right? We have Allison Felix. She has a ton of training partners. How are you able to do that without a training partner?
I don't know. I just always train well by myself. Ever since I left college, I've been by myself. So I don't think it's a big deal for me to train without anyone.
And you realize that everybody's going to be trying to come into your camp now. You understand?
Yeah, I understand.
Okay.
That.
Congratulations.
Thanks.
Again. Okay. Any appetizers? Time for some meat. The 2012 Performance of the Year Award recognizes what has been chosen as the one outstanding performance of the year. To present the Female 2012 Performance of the Year Award, please welcome on stage the greatest 400-meter hurdler of all time, Edwin Moses. So what is it about your event and gold medals 8 years apart? You did it, Angelo Taylor did it, and then Felix Sanchez did it this year. Is there something about, unlikely that a 100-meter sprinter can do that. What is it about that event where, if you're good, you can somehow find a way to keep it going that long?
Well, if it wasn't for the boycott in 1980, I'd
obviously.
Probably.
You'd have probably had three. We wouldn't have, be having this discussion,
yeah,
correct?
And a bad day at the office in 88.
Uh-huh.
For me, it was
those Bruins.
The office, yeah.
Yeah.
So, you know, the 400 hurdles is a tough event, and it takes a lot of experience, you know, to really get to the top. I mean, for Kevin, it took him. Kevin was struggling.
That's right.
You know, years and years from the time he was a freshman at UCLA, I saw him run, you know, for most of my career.
Right.
And, you know, he started out as a 51-50 guy, and he improved all the way. Andre the same way, so it's an event that requires a lot of experience.
Absolutely. Okay, Female Performance of the Year.
Okay, and the winner of the 2012 Performance of the Year Award is the USA 4x100 Relay Team.
The U.S., obviously, 2011 notwithstanding, you guys have had some bad luck with getting that stick around. Is there something that changed with this team, the chemistry, the practice, the coaching? What changed with this team that allowed you guys to not only win at the Olympic Games, but to break up, to smash that record?
I think our attitude's changed. You know, the past is the past, and, you know, it's not good to focus on things that, you know, we had no control over. We had great chemistry and we ran together earlier part of the year, and I think we're just more confident in ourselves, and we knew that if we got to stick around, we'll do something great, and we did.
So you became collectively the first team to ever go under 41 seconds flat. Is that really sunk in yet? Because I look at the time sometimes and I go, wait a minute, oh, you know, that's right, they are under 41. Is that sunk in yet?
No, We were just talking about it earlier. It definitely has a thing in it.
Well, congratulations again. Now, if I told you this young man came from, and notice I said young man, came from New Zealand, you'd probably stop complaining about the travel some of you had to have to come here. Ladies and gentlemen, he's not quite from New Zealand anymore. He's lived in Texas for quite some time. Please welcome Mr. Peter Snell, three-time Olympic champion, to present the Male Performance of the Year Award. Make sure to put the young in there.
Right.
Now, of course, your exploits were at 800 and 1500, but now you have a fantastic champion in Valerie Billy. What has she meant to New Zealand athletics?
She's carried on the tradition of gold medalists, of which we're very proud, and we'll even take a shot for her.
Okay, absolutely. There you go. Performance of the Year, male.
Need these to see. Well, there is no runner that I prefer to present this to. The Performance of the Year Award is David Rudisha.
Sitting in the stadium, the first lap happens, 49-2, and I go, okay, so this is going to be a win, but this is not going to be a world record today. When you stepped to the line in that stadium, was the focus win first, don't worry about the time, or did you have just a little bit of an inkling of, you know what, I'm in fantastic shape, and now is my moment, I'm going for both?
Well, when I was in that line, I knew I was in good shape. And I was confident to win the race, but I wanted to do something special. Probably, I knew it was difficult to break the world record without a pacemaker.
Yes.
But I was going for something like 141. But in the long run, I got the world record.
It was an amazing performance. I think the performance of the game is the goal of the team. Congratulations. Ladies and gents, we are very close to the moment we have all been waiting for, the announcement of the World Athletes of the Year. First, the ladies. In order to present this very prestigious award, please join me in welcoming on stage His Serene Highness, Prince Albert of Monaco.
Giving me the ability to do what I love, to be able to run, and to be able to use my gift to give him glory. And a big thank you to the IAAF for recognizing my achievements this year. It's really, London was just a dream come true for me. And I have a huge support system, and so I thank my family for all the sacrifices that they've made for me, and I thank my coach, Bobby Kersey, who's really just been a guiding light in my career. And even though at times we disagree, and you know, he's a tough one, but I just appreciate being under his wisdom and just being able to be his student, and I'm just so grateful for that. And 9 years ago, I think it was, I attended the IAAF Gala in Monaco, and I was 17 years old, didn't know anything about the gala. I was just happy to be getting a free trip to Monaco. Yes. So I was there that evening, and I received the Rising Star Award with Usain. And I guess the IAAF knew something that I didn't, because I had no idea that I would be on this journey. And along the way, there's been lots of ups and downs. I would be lying if I said it was just, it's been smooth sailing, but it's been a true journey. And my biggest defeats have always seemed to come at the Olympic Games. And I'm grateful for those experiences. But after Beijing, I was truly devastated. There was no consoling me. No one could say anything that would make me feel any better, because I had worked the hardest I thought was possible, and I had still come up short, and I didn't know if I ever would reach the top. And so after that experience, I decided to rededicate myself and just to continue to be motivated, you know, even if I never would reach the top. But I think it was really a blessing in disguise that I went through that experience, because I was able to work harder than I did even the year before, and finally, things came together for me. And so I can appreciate it more now. I can appreciate the things that I went through, and I can appreciate this honor to be recognized at the top of my sport as something I never, ever would have imagined. So I'm extremely grateful. My heart is filled with gratitude. Thank you for this huge, huge privilege.
The Male World Athlete of the Year Award. Please welcome on stage the IAAF President, Mr. Lamine Diang.
And the winner of the 2012 World Athlete of the Year is Usain Bolt.
Albert, President Lamine Diang, Mayor of Barcelona, fellow athletes, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. Yes. For me, this is a great honor this year. I really worked hard. I really focused. So for me, it's an honor to win for my fourth time. I think that's a world record. Yes. Yeah. For me, it was just a pleasure to really come out this season. It was one of my toughest seasons, I think. I went through a few ups and downs. A lot of people don't know about, because my coach doesn't like us athletes to talk about injuries. He doesn't like us to focus on the injuries, but just to work through them and be focused. I would like to thank my coach, Glenn Mills. Dr. Glenn Mills. I like that he really is the greatest coach, hands down. He's helped young Blake, young Warren Weir. He got 6 gold medals this season at the Olympics. So for me, that's just a great standard. He's a legend for me in my book, without a doubt. It was a pleasure. I'd like to thank my sponsors for everything they helped me through a lot this year. I'd like to thank my family and friends, my team. I don't want to name everyone, but I want to thank them all. I want to thank the fans, which for me is one of the biggest things at this London Games here. It was magnificent. It was surprising, because they came out from 10 in the morning, and it was always full. The stadium was always full. So for me, that was one of the most surprising moments. I've really enjoyed this season. Continue to work hard. I'd like to thank God for everything, because without him, this wouldn't be possible. I'd like to thank the IAAF also for everything they have done over the years to help to push the athletes to move forward and to build ourselves to be great. As Alison said earlier, back here now, so for me it's a pleasure. That says I'm getting old, so I'm slightly worried. But I'm just going to continue working hard. I'm looking forward to the upcoming season, and just going to work hard and try to be the best at what I do. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, the 2012 World Athletes of the Year. And so, ladies and gents, we thank you for a truly memorable ceremony. Allow me to thank you all for having taken part in this historical award presentation and to congratulate all of these wonderful athletes who have made 2012 such a special and memorable year. Thank you. Goodbye. We'll see you tonight at the gala. Good afternoon.